something real awareness that can work. For personal breathing, as the three knots of your breathing, inhale fully through your belly, then rise up. Body weight, notice it's forward, so hip, neck, back, legs are all in one straight line, okay? So we don't want our butts to be too high there. Down, low. Alright, so hold, and go slightly lower. Hold your abdominal muscles, slightly lower. And hold there, hip forward in front of you. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, knees down, exhale, push back to child's pose. And then child's pose for one breath. Inhale fully. Exhale completely. Good. Then from here, just go ahead. Inhale, come up to tabletop posture. So in tabletop, you want to make sure our alignment is correct as well. Make sure that the eye of your elbow, which is this line, right? Okay, this line is pointing forward. So if you feel that it's like this, rotate, consciously rotate it forward. Okay. And then your elbows close to your body, shift your body inside, so you are leaning side forward. Okay. Then think about keeping your elbows close to your body, alright? And then fold forward side. Then requires a lot of hand strength, form muscles as well. You come all the way down into Ashtanga Muscle. Okay. So it's like you're doing a push up. Slowly, slowly, and all the way down. Yes. Good. Okay, so these are knees, chest, chin. So be mindful of the points in our body that's touching the mat, the chin, the palms, the knees, and the face. That's why it's got the feet on the face. From here, inhale, all the way up to the left, pull up. Feet pull up, so why don't you let our shoulders push through our palms, okay? Then look up. So you can look up, you realize that you suddenly go deeper into the posture, you can feel your lower back. At the same time, when we look up, we are stretching the front of our neck. We do that, we are activating our thyroid, which governs our metabolic. So, one more time, we'll talk under up. Lift off to downward facing dog. Again, take your option, remember you guys are partially in your own practice. To feel like walking the dog, you can bring your hand in your leg and hand right here. Against the mat, shift your body weight to your lower body. Push. Okay, now hold, holding downward dog. Okay, check the other hand. Okay, see your feet. Shut up in the whole arm. Push. Push yourself down the hips. Okay, your feet as well. Shift here. Push through your palms. Good. So try to remember the alignment, try to remember how it feels. From here, inhale, knees down. Exhale, push back to child's pose. Okay. In child's pose, you can choose to tuck your toes under. So allow yourself to go even deeper to your posture. But if you like to tuck your toes in, that's entirely fine as well. Okay. Stay here for one breath. Inhale fully. And exhale. certainty. Then once again, tuck the heels under, lift up to downward facing dog. Okay. Downward dog, inhale, right leg up, three-legged dog. Right leg all the way up to the sky. Then exhale, right leg in between your hands, so we are back in our horse pose, but on the other side. Alright, check your alignment, shift your leg forward if you have to. So one of the most important things is that we want to make sure that we keep this 90 degree angle, and we don't want our knees at any point in time to go over our toes. Because when we do this, right, we are putting a lot of weight on our knees and we end up under. So always make sure that it's like this. Okay, hold it down. Pause a little bit. Okay. Open up your hips. Then let's do cobra with twist. So just twist and look over your right shoulder. So this posture is very good for our digestion. Inhale back to center. Exhale, left shoulder. Remember to breathe always. And inhale back to center. Tuck your toes under and lift off. A little bit of balance. So shift your body weight gently to the left, release your right hand and place your right hand on your left knee. Okay, then if you can, slide it all the way down until you touch your left knee. Yes, if not, just leave it at your knees. Okay, and slowly back to the downward facing dog. Oh, it's then this time, shift your body weight to the right. Release your left hand, raise it on your right heels, then slide it all the way down to your right ankles if you can, and hold. Back to downward facing dog. Inhale knees down, exhale push back to the dog. Slow down, breathe. Inhale fully, and exhale completely. come back up to our down dog facing dog. This time, let's inhale, left it all the way up to the sky. Exhale, left it between your hands. So we are in our cross pose. So just shift your body weight up so you are really on your toes. So you are on your toes. From here, engage your core muscles from all the way up to your high lunge, inhale, and exhale. Inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, one more time, inhale up, and exhale down, and hold. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rotate over to the right, back to center, and rotate over to the left, back to center, and up. Exhale, bring your hands down. Inhale, drop. Exhale, drop it forward, send it forward, forward. And inhale, come all the way up. Step back in. And exhale. Sit, push your butt back. Let's do a chair pose. So bring your both feet together. Push your butt back. And make sure that your back is not curved, straight. And then slowly push down. Make sure that your knees are not over your toes. Again, both feet together will form that V shape. Yes. Hold. So you don't have to sing too well actually. Just start in. Then hold. Hands together, straighten your hands. Ask yourself to your hands. Hold. Can you feel your thighs? Yes. Inhale up. Slide back down once more. Exhale. Hands. Good. Two more rounds. In up. Step back in. Exhale. Go forwards. And then forward, forward. This time, inhale. Right leg all the way back. And inhale, knees down. So right knee down. Okay. Ground your right palms onto the mat. Flip your left hand up into the sky. For those of you who want to go even deeper, you could straighten your right leg. Have the toes under, straighten your right leg. Hands up, twist. Hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right knee down once again, then bend your right leg up. Use your left hand to catch your right leg. Good. Shift your body weight forward, and then bring your heels all the way to your glutes. Okay? Feel that hot stretch. Yes. And hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Gently allow your leg to touch back down to the ground. From here, walk your left leg all the way to the side of your mat. So walk to the side. Good. Side of the mat. Bring your left hand in. Okay, and then you're coming down to our knees and posture. Want to knees down, if you want to straighten your right leg, see if you go even deeper into the posture. You rest your forehead on your palms. Hold. Feel your hip open. So in yoga, we actually believe that we hold a lot of emotions and negative flow within our hips. So when you do more hip openness, as we become more flexible, we release all these emotions out. Align your knees, come back down to the mat, come back onto your other mouth, set your mouth in front of you. Then from here, just collapse that knee out. So it's called a wing tip, right? So you feel the pressure points along the side of the feet. And quite intense posture. It's like giving yourself a nice foot with that solo gym. Good for those who walk around, walk on the path. Once again, plank, butt's not high up in the sky, so shift your body weight in. So shift your body weight in, come up to your toes. Thank you. Inhale knees down, exhale, push back to child's pose. Catch your breath, inhale fully. Exhale completely. One more time, inhale fully. And exhale completely. Good. From here, let's go ahead and come back up to our downward facing dog. Let's do some core work. So inhale, right leg up into the sky. Yes. Exhale, right knee to right elbow, feet still floating off the mat. So body forward, same knee, same elbow. Good. Inhale up. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Good. One last time, inhale up. Then right knee to right elbow. And hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale up. Exhale, down. Let's do it on the left. Inhale, left leg all the way up, shift the front. Exhale, left knee, left elbow. Good. Shift the body leg forward, shift up. Deep breathe and move. Inhale up, step up. Exhale, knees to elbow. One last time, inhale up. Let's see your feet up. Let's knees to elbow. And let's hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2, inhale up. Exhale, left foot down. Inhale, knees down. Exhale, push the chest. Once again, always check your alignment. Make sure that your middle fingers is parallel, then allow your fingers to stretch as wide as possible. So even when we are shifting between postures, try to keep this posture. So sometimes, as we move into a posture that requires a little bit more work, we might shift. Okay, we might forget about our wrist and we end up injuring ourselves. So let's try not to do that. Good. Okay. So for those of you who want to challenge yourself, you could take a push-up position, plank. Okay. Inhale, plank. Then exhale. So those of you who are doing, carry on doing your Ashtanga Namaskara, if you would like to, do your Chaturanga Dandasana with your push-ups. Hold while floating. Oh, Sangha Namaskara, press all the way together. Go for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Allow yourself to just come all the way down to your mat, straighten your legs, knees and bare leg. Place your palms on opposite shoulders, round your heels onto the mat. Toes pointing to opposite directions. Breath, so chin in between the hands, please cross to the right. This is called a wrestling crocodile position. Inhale fully. Exhale completely. One more time. Inhale. And exhale completely. On the left, so then you can in front of you. Then bend both legs. Use your respective hands. Use your respective controls. Bring your big toes. You actively bring your knees together if you can. Then as you inhale, go ahead and keep up your legs. Bring your chest up from the back. Squeeze your glutes, squeeze your butts. Bring your thighs off the mat as well. Good. And then hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Absolutely. Shift the knees. And then opposite shoulder. Round the glutes. So that was our goal pose. So goal pose was opening our chest, and our shoulder, and squeezing our glutes, and our quads, and including the lower back as well. So it's definitely your training, kind of like moving forward. One more time, let's go kick and sit on this floor. Bend your legs, catch your respective ankles, bring big toes together, actively do moves to you. And inhale, bring it in the lower back, allow your quads, the thighs to lift up, and up, out, up, up, chest, and back, or top, and 1, 3, 2. Thank you. place your palms below your chest. So yeah. Good. So you find that. Then push yourself all the way up. See? Cobra posture. Once again, knees on the back. You can just maybe go deep into that back bend. Slowly allow your feet to touch back down the mat. Good. Then shift your right leg to the side of the mat. Good. Bring your hands in. Come down to your forearms. Pull up back now with the pose. Still. Rest your head. Okay. Feel your feet open. The left, lift your right feet up just 1 inch off the mat and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shift your body weight to the right, lift left leg up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release, four, pressure. Your heart sounds good. One last round of pressing tension. Inhale, shut that band once again. Exhale, fold all the way forward. Stepping forward, four. This time, inhale, left leg, all the way back. Okay? So, look here. Okay, round your left leg down. Perform this perpendicular line, 90 degrees. Heels to heels, this is one straight line. Good. Then, bring you, so, rotate the other side.
your feet now.
Yes, very good.
Then we'll take out into warrior two.
So in warrior two, our right leg will be pointed forwards. Then we want to sink low into the posture. Your hips will be 45 degrees to the left. Okay. Hands up. Hold. Thank you. upwards to your posterior. Inhale and look up. Exhale, hip forwards and hip forward flow. Once again, exhale as you're all passing. Now go ahead and separate your feet to about shoulder width apart. Palms facing forward, close your eyes, stepping your awareness back inwards.